Hello everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about knapsack problem by using backtracking concept. We already discussed knapsack problem in our greedy approach. Also we discussed in our dynamic programming. And today in this video we are going to solve same problem by using backtracking concept. So let us start our today's video on knapsack problem by using backtracking concept. First of all, you must understand what is knapsack problem. As per the problem statement, suppose we have one knapsack. Knapsack is nothing but one bag, and we have a number of objects. Every object has some weight and value. For example, this is one object and the weight of this object is 3 unit and the value is 45. Same way, this is second object and the weight of this object is 5 unit and the value is equal to 30. Same way, every object has some weight and value. Now we have to fill this all the object inside this knapsack, inside this bag. But this bag or knapsack has one capacity constraint. This capacity constraint is known as M. It means that our knapsack can carry maximum M unit of weight. So when we place or when we fill different object inside the knapsack, at that time we must check that total weight of knapsack must be less than or is equal to capital M, because our knapsack can carry maximum M unit of weight. Now what is goal or what is objective is, we have to maximize total profit or total value of our knapsack with this constraint, that is total weight of knapsack must be less than or is equal to capital M. Now in our greedy method we can divide our object into different parts, but now in this backtracking concept we cannot divide our object into different parts. So we have an object which cannot be divided into different parts. So let us solve one example by using backtracking concept. As you know that in our backtracking concept we have a certain steps that we need to follow. So the step number one, arrange object in non-decreasing order of vi divided by wi. We have to arrange object in non-decreasing order of value divided by weight. This is actually the concept of a greedy approach, in that we are arranging all the objects into the non-decreasing order of vi divided by wi. Same step we need to follow here. Step number two, find upper bound value. Once we solve same example by using greedy approach, at that time we can get maximum profit, maximum value. This value is known as upper bound. Step number three, draw state space tree. Step number four, follow DFS, that is our depth first search. And last step, explore node based on the bounding function. Here bounding function is nothing but our upper bound value. And how we can find upper bound value? Upper bound value is nothing but it is a value which can be generated by applying greedy approach. In greedy approach we can divide our object into different parts, but in our backtracking concept we cannot divide our object into different parts. Let us solve one example. Suppose we have a different objects. For example, x1 is one object, x2, x3 and x4, different four objects are there. Every object has some weight and value. The value of first object is 45 and weight is equal to 3. Value of second object is 30 and weight is equal to 5. Same way, the last object has a value 10 and weight is equal to 5. And the capacity constraint of our knapsack is M is equal to 16. It means that our knapsack can carry maximum 16 unit of weight. So before filling this object inside the knapsack, we need to check that total weight must not be greater than 16, or it must be less than or is equal to 16. Now as we discuss, every time we have to identify the upper bound value, and that value we can find by using a greedy approach. So let us start to make one state space tree first. State space tree is nothing but it is a tree which represents all the possible solutions, just like our brute force approach. But in our state space tree, we are adding some constraint, that is our bounding function, and we follow depth first search algorithm. So let us do state space tree for this problem. So in our state space tree, we have a number of nodes. We have to start from the root node, and then we have to explore one by one node as per the bounding function. So let us start from the root node. Our first root node is, this is our first root node. Every node in this state space tree has some value. For example, this root node has CV is equal to 0 and CW is equal to 0. This CV is nothing but a current value of our knapsack, it is 0, and the current weight of knapsack, it is equal to 0, because still we have not filled any object inside the knapsack, so that the total weight and total value of our knapsack is 0. Now we need to identify upper bound. This UB is nothing but our upper bound, and upper bound of our knapsack is 115. It means that if we follow greedy approach to solve this problem, at that time our answer will be 115. Just check whether it is correct or not. For example, if we follow our greedy approach, then as per the greedy approach, we have to arrange this list of object into non-decreasing order of vi divided by wi. So it is already in a non-decreasing order of vi divided by wi, because our first value is 15, vi divided by wi, first value is 15, then after 6, then after 5, and then after 2. So it is already in non-decreasing order of vi divided by wi. So let us solve by using greedy approach. As per the greedy approach, we have to select our first object. So select first object x1, which has a value is equal to 45 and weight is equal to 3. Then select our second object, which has a value is equal to 30 and weight is equal to 5. So total weight of our knapsack is 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. And the capacity constraint is 16. So still we can add another object. So let us add another object, that is object number 3. So when we add object number 3, at that time total weight will be more than 16, because the weight of our object number 3 is 9 and current weight of our knapsack is 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. So 8 plus 9 is equal to 17, which is larger than the 16. It means that we cannot fill object number 3 fully inside our knapsack, otherwise the total weight will be more than the 16, and it is not allowed. So that we have to divide our object number 3 into different parts. But one thing you need to note down here, in our backtracking we cannot divide our object into different parts. But here we are just assuming that if we can divide into different parts, at that time what will be the upper bound, right? And so that we are applying here greedy method to assume, if we apply our greedy method, at that time what will be the upper bound value. So we are just assuming that, suppose if we divide our object into different parts, if we can divide our object into different parts, at that time we can select 8 out of 9. Right, so total weight will be 3 plus 5 is equal to 8, 8 plus 8 is equal to 16. So we have to just divide our object number 3 into different parts, and we can select 8 out of 9. Same way, we can get value, that is 40 out of 45. So the total value will be 45 plus 30, that is 75, 75 plus 40 is equal to 115. And this 115 is known as upper bound. It means that maximum value we can get, that is 115. But here we cannot divide our object into different parts. So based on this upper bound value, we have to explore the node. So let us explore this node. Currently we have not selected any object, so that the current value of our knapsack is 0 and current weight of knapsack is 0. Now we have a first choice, either we are selecting object number 1 or not. If we select object number 1, it means that x1 is equal to 1. It indicates that we are selecting object number 1. or we are not selecting object number 1, that is x1 is equal to 0. So when we select object number 1, at that time the current value of our knapsack will be 45 and current weight of our knapsack will be 3, because our object number 1 has a value 45 and weight is equal to 3. So now object number 1 is available inside the knapsack, so the current weight of our knapsack will be 3 and current value of our knapsack will be 45. Now we need to check upper bound value. Upper bound value is as it is 115, because in this case we have selected x1. Now another option is, if we are not selecting our first object to fill the knapsack, so that x1 is equal to 0. It means that we are not filling our x1 object or our first object inside the knapsack. It means that we have to start from the object number 2. So current value and weight of our knapsack is 0, because still we have not filled any object inside the knapsack. So current weight is equal to 0 and current value of our knapsack is equal to 0. Now we need to identify upper bound. If we are not selecting our first object, for example our first object, that is our x1, we are not going to use x1 to fill the knapsack, so that we have to start from the second object. So let us first select our second object. Our second object has a value is equal to 30 and weight is equal to 5. Now we have to select our third object, which has a value 45 and weight is equal to 9. Now total weight is 5 plus 9 is equal to 14, and our capacity of our knapsack is 16, so still we can select our third object, that is our object number 4. Now object number 4 has value is equal to 10 and weight is equal to 5. So 5 plus 14 is equal to 19, which is larger than the 16. It means that we cannot fill a full object inside the knapsack. So we have to divide our fourth object into different parts. So we need to check that out of these 5, we can use only 2 unit of weight. So we have to just select 2 out of 5. So the total will be 5 plus 9 is equal to 14. 14 plus 2 is equal to 16. So that accordingly we have to identify the value also. Out of this 10, we can select 4 only. So the total value will be 30 plus 45, that is 75. 75 plus 4 is equal to 79. So the upper bound value is 79. Now we have to just check that we have a two node. One has upper bound 115 and second has upper bound 79. So which node we need to explore? So definitely we have to further explore this node, because this node has upper bound 115 and this node has upper bound 79. This upper bound indicates that if we follow this path, at that time there may be a chance that we will have a maximum value 115, and if we follow this path, at that time there may be a chance that we will have a maximum value, that is 79. And as per our knapsack problem, our basic goal is we have to maximize the value. So we have to select this object for the further exploration. So let us explore this node further. When we explore this node further, at that time again we have a two option, because we have already selected object number 1. So now we can select object number 2. So we have two options: either we are selecting object number 2 or we are not selecting object number 2. Once we select object number 2, at that time x2 is equal to 1. Once we are not selecting object number 2, at that time x2 is equal to 0. Once we select object number 2, for example, at that time our current value of our knapsack will be 75 and current weight of our knapsack will be 8. Because we have selected first x1, which has a value 45, then we have selected x2, which has a value 30. So 45 plus 30 is equal to 75. So total weight of our total value of our knapsack will be 75. And we have selected first object, which has a weight 3, and then after second object, which has a weight 5. So 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. So the current weight, or we can say the total weight of our knapsack currently, is 8 unit. Now we need to check upper bound. upper bound is again 115 because we have already selected x2 in our greedy approach. So still our upper bound is 115. Now, as we discuss every time, we need to check that total weight must not be more than the 16. Here still it is 8, so we can further exploration is possible. Now, if we are not selecting, for example, x2, so x2 is equal to 0, then the current value of our knapsack is equal to 45 and current weight of our knapsack is equal to 3 because we have not selected x2. So inside the our knapsack we have only one object, that is our object number 1, which has a value 45 and weight is equal to 3. Now we need to check upper bound because we have selected x1 object but we are not going to select x2 object, so that we can select either x3, x4 like that, so that we need to identify the upper bound. So you can use the same method, that is your greedy method, to identify the upper bound, and you will get upper bound value, that is 98. Now we have a 3 node. The first node has a upper bound 115, this node has a upper bound 98, and this node has a upper bound 79. So which node we need to select? We have to select the node which has a higher upper bound. So definitely we have to explore this node further. When we explore this node further, at that time we have selected object number 1, then after we have selected object number 2, so now we have a 2 option. Either we can select object number 3 or we are not selecting object number 3. Once we select object number 3, x3 is equal to 1, at that time the current value of our knapsack will be 120 and current weight of our knapsack will be 17, which is larger than the capacity of the knapsack. It means that we cannot select this object, right? So as per the backtracking concept, we need to go back and we need to choose another option. Now another option is, if we are not selecting object number 3, if we are not going to select object number 3, at that time current value will be 75, current weight will be 8, and our upper bound will be 85. You have to calculate this upper bound in same method in that we are using greedy approach. So the upper bound will be 85. Now we have a 3 node which can be explored. So this is the first node which has a upper bound 85, this node has a upper bound 98, and this node has a upper bound 79. So definitely we have to explore this node further. So we have to just go back and we have to identify another option which has the upper bound maximum. So as per the backtracking concept, we need to go back and we have to identify another option. So this is the better option where we have to explore the node. So explore this node. So once we explore this node, at that time again we have a 2 option. First option, that is if we select object number 3 or we are not selecting object number 3. When we select object number 3, at that time total value of our knapsack will be 90 and total weight of our knapsack will be 12, and you have to identify the upper bound, then the upper bound value will be 98. Same way, if we are not selecting object number 3, at that time our current value will be 45 and current weight will be 3 and upper bound will be 55. Now we have 4 different nodes that can be explored. This is the first node, second node, third node and fourth node. Among that, we need to identify the node which has a maximum upper bound. So this node has upper bound 98, which is larger among these 3. So we have to explore this node further. When we explore this node further, at that time we have 2 options. Either we are selecting object number 4 or we are not selecting object number 4. Once we select object number 4, at that time the current value will be 100 and current weight will be 17, which is larger than the capacity constraint. So we cannot select this object. So we have to check another option. We have to just go back and we need to check another option. If we are not selecting x4, or we can say object number 4, at that time the current value will be 90 and current weight is equal to 12. Now we have three nodes which can be explored further. This node can be explored further which has upper bound 85. This node can be explored further which has upper bound 55. And this node can be explored further which has upper bound 79. Among these three, this node has upper bound 85. So once we explore this node, at that time there may be a chance that we will have a maximum value 85. But once we observe here, at that time the current value of our knapsack is 90, which is larger among all. So this is the answer. So the maximum value of our knapsack is 90. If we select object number 1, then after we are not selecting object number 2, then we select object number 3, and if we not select object number 4. So the answer is 1010. It indicates that we have selected object number 1, then we have not selected object number 2, we have selected object number 3, we have not selected object number 4. And this is the answer. So this is all about how we can find a solution of our knapsack problem by using backtracking concept. So thank you very much for watching this video.